cheer around Noida and Greater Noida Real Estate. First, the excitement of the new airport at Jewar, with two runways likely to be ready by 2023. Now, the UP government has budgeted another 2,000 crore rupees for the airport runways to go up to six. The UP government's also decided to allot 700 acres for Electronic City's manufacturing hub. And you have IKEA announcing setting up its largest store in Sector 51 of Noida. Our question, is this region's housing market poised for a re-rating? My guest, Kitambar Anand, Chairman and Managing Director of ATS Infrastructure Limited, Sameer Jasuja, Founder and CEO of Prop Equity. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me. Kitambar, what's happening? I'm getting a lot of SMSs on buying land, and I hear people asking me, should we go ahead and quickly grab something in Noida because prices are going to run away?
So my first warning to all prospective buyers of land is, please don't buy land. Buy land which is already developed by Noida, because Noida has a policy wherein you cannot buy land from the farmer and get a license done for that particular land. All land is acquired by the authorities under the Noida Act, and they then auction and sell these plots of land, which you can buy as whenever they are advertised. Yes, there is a definite positive buzz about this region, and it's about time, because we've been shouting hoarse that the infrastructure of this tri-city is one of the best in the country, I would say. And there is no reason why this market shouldn't grow. Yes, there are lots of plots available in developed sectors in Noida, and the prices right now are very good. There are ample apartments to choose from, because Noida is one destination which provides an opportunity to every and each buyer in the entire spectrum of the pyramid of demand.
Very interesting. Sameer, I'm looking at, the data which has come from Prop Equity, total residential supply, about 3.63 lakh units. And we're looking at Noida and Greater Noida, which includes the Yamuna Expressway and Noida Extension. Just the data alone tells me that there is not too much of ready units unsold supply, but there still continues to be a fair amount of under construction unsold supply. Just decode the data for us in terms of what is the price movement expected?
Well, price movement as we speak, I don't see any price appreciation for the next 1 or 2 years, at least. There is a lot of under construction projects that still have to be completed in Noida, Greater Noida belt. As far as Noida market is concerned, it should also be compared to Gurgaon a little bit in terms of supply numbers. So when we look at Noida and Greater Noida together, roughly double the amount of supply that has come in Gurgaon. Today, 135,000 units are ready in Gurgaon, and over 244,000 units are ready in Noida, Greater Noida, and another 130,000 have to be completed in the next 3 to 4 years. Overall supply in Gurgaon is about 97 million square feet, whereas Noida is about 37 million square feet. So it's one third the overall commercial market of Gurgaon.
Okay, Sameer, I'm going to just decode the numbers very, very quickly. What you've said is that the housing supply is almost double of what it is in Gurgaon. That is Noida's and Greater Noida's housing supply. However, commercial is about half of what it is in Gurgaon. Is that correct?
One third.
All right, one third. Okay, so that's the easy number to decode. Kitambar Anand, that is the gap that one has always wondered whether Jewar will be able to close. What do you think? And when?
Absolutely. So, Manisha, here it is. That is the opportunity, I would say. You see, in the last calendar year, 2020 and till now in 21, 1.7 billion square foot of commercial space has been leased in Noida alone. And suddenly, you see the end users. We've got Yes Bank coming up over here in Delhi One. Some big names, Microsoft has come over here. So, suddenly there's an attraction for Noida as a destination for office space, because it's very, very right. The price is right. The lease rentals are very, very reasonable. The infrastructure is great. And suddenly the fear of Noida being the Wild West is no longer there. So you'll see in the coming year, and with Jewar coming up, and with so much development happening over here with data centers, warehousing, airport generating more employment, and more factories and industries coming up in the Electronic City, etc., etc., you'll suddenly see a good demand for office space, and that will, as a reaction, it will generate a lot of employment and demand for good housing, which is reasonably priced, which is what we see in Sameer's data.
All right. Sameer, would you agree with that, at least if Jewar will be the game changer for commercial real estate. The reason why Gurgaon became so much more popular with the top MNCs is because Gurgaon had an airport. The next 5 years, could there be a complete re-rating in terms of commercial and therefore then for housing market?
It's really too early to say right now because the airport is a good 3 to 5 years away from being fully operational, and the impact of that is yet to be seen. B, Gurgaon in itself is offering a lot of commercial supply, and the airport is right over here. In fact, two airports are right over here. So I don't see too many multinationals moving for 30-40 rupees differential in rental, especially with post-COVID scenario where there is this work from home culture that is also going to be emerging, where the commercial demand in itself is going to come down in the near future.
All right. Okay, we're going to keep it at that, because what I'm hearing is that, okay, don't go crazy about the market. Do not definitely start buying land as individual investors. It's a great mid-segment housing market. The prices, average prices of housing inventory in Noida is much lower, with probably comparable, in better than comparable infrastructure than Gurgaon and connectivity to Delhi. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me. We'll keep these kind of conversations going. I'm going to wrap out here. Thank you very much for joining me on The Property Show.